Everybody, it's 41. Welcome back to Metroid Prime Trilogy Prime Metroid. Last time, I fooled around with the Spire Ball quite a bit. And this time around, well, we have something we can collect. At first, we have a bunch of idiots. Shriek bats are mean. Also, I think those things are shaking at me. They're shaking their booties. If they had booties. What would you call... What do you call plants behind? What would you call plants behind? Is it a booty? Is it an ass? Is it a... What do you call plants behind? I love if I'm saying behind now. I never say behind. I said behind all the time. Not behind. Ugh. Anyway. Yeah, I just completely jumped into the shriek bats because I'm good like that. I'm a pimp. But anyway, we have the means to do stuff here now. So we go up through here. We have to race because, yep, they have to make you do this. Or that could happen. That did happen. I don't know what I did there, but I did something. You will all bow down before the great Samus. You knaves! Well, the Beatles don't get it. When I'm on a platform, you can't do shit. Also, what is this otherworldly pestilence that infests our land, seeking out life to blind you for corruption? Where that meteor that brought it originate? Was it corrupted by alien hands, or is that a roving chunk of a planet that suffered a violent end? A mighty little hole. It's like Babu almost. It's a great poison!
Great poison!
Whatever cataclysm may have ruptured the tomb place may have been mighty indeed. And if other beings also ruptures ran throughout this. For some reason, doing that voice reminds me of, I was watching those, C-SPAN, some of those prank calls. Like, am I on the air? Yes. Fuck!
Yes, good morning, sir. My name is Dickbag von Nutsack. I want to ask you, what do you think of Howard Stern's penis?
Also, we can't do anything about the story yet. Hope you realize that. That's why I was dancing around like an idiot. Also, too, because I wanted to finish that stupidly retarded thought of Howard Stern's penis, which is not something one should be thinking of at any point in time. Although, apparently, outside of the thing, Howard Stern is nothing like that. It's kind of like Jerry Springer is nothing like what he is on the show. And the morbid music comes back. And yes, I do think it's morbid music. Also, another one of those. Which means we must be getting close to something of importance.
And another chosen lord.
None know if our temple, the cradle, will powerful enough to contain this evil forever. For now, it wraps around that abomination, cutting it off from the world above. We believe the power of Cypher, which has been linked to the 12 artifacts, should be strong enough. That it's approaching.
That voice I've never done before. Will I do it ever again? Probably not. But anyway, it's Extreme X Games time with the Metroids. So, yeah. Watch Samus go up, up, and away! Fail. Watch Samus go up, up, and away! Success. Da, 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 da. Anyway, there is something we could do here. Namely a magnetic system, a rail track thing, but for some reason, they're all retracted. And I just... Wait a minute. Wait.
Duh, I swear I played this game before, guys. I mean, I'm pretty smart.
Okay, they are retracted. Alright. So yeah, I can't really do shit about that at this point in time, unless... Hold on. Something didn't look right. Oh, okay. Okay, I've never seen this one before.
To the entrusted one! If you read these words, then our hope is not in vain. Your path is fraught with danger. Monstrosities beyond description lurk in the shadows, starving, hunting for prey. We are 11 parts in, guys, and we just learned this. Really, why'd you put a damn sign outside? Put a danger sign, Chozo or something. I put the keep off the grass. There are creatures abound here that are horrible and will look to pierce your armor and eat your flesh and dance on you to and play tap dancing games on your body, on your lifeless carcass. If you still have the need to go further, then seek us out. We will help you.
That'd be the worst sign ever. Everybody who sees this would be like, yipes, gotta run. Okay. Some of them are shrewd, some are blind by evil designs.
Great poison! You'll be the true and trusted one when you do shit.
When you rid the universe of these creatures,
you'll be the true and trusted one.
I knew it! Okay, I gotta scan this so someone will activate. And it's actually the magnetic systems, which suddenly mysteriously appear. So now, it's time to do Metroid X games again. So,
another one? How many of these are there?
I missed a bunch of these. Machos are gifted with the distance sight, as even more begin to learn as our harmonization with the universe, which is humongous big, becomes more and more complete. We peer for it, seeing prophecy in the ripples of the weather, hearing rumors of the coming days of the breath of the wind. These visions are dark, the worst of prophecies, and the most common, telling of the coming of
the Worm! Oh no! Sky Tuati's the final boss in this game? No! I love that move!
Those are my favorite moves, the Worm. Born from parasites.
Nurtured in the poison womb!
The Worm grows, devouring from within, until the world begins to rot. And all of prophecies come to pass, but of course we can't help this fear, but this dark portent. Didn't stop Howard Camp, what was his name? Harold Camping from telling us his thoughts on how the universe is gonna blow up. This is some talking about doomsday theories and crazy, weird, extra stuff that I have no idea about. I have a question. This is if you don't believe it, if you believe in the Big Bang Theory. I mean, I've heard of this, and I'm not going to go into ridiculing anybody, but there's been one reason why I never believed in the Big Bang Theory. What created the Big Bang Theory? Or what created the Big Bang, I should say. That was always the big thing that actually made me think, you know what, I'm not going to believe the Big Bang because of that. I mean, I know that's what people say, it's the Big Bang and all that stuff, but honestly, that's the one thing I've never wrapped my head around. Because I'm a feeble-minded person and not an intellect. Am I going the right way? No, because I am a feeble-minded human being and not an intellect. I think. I can't tell if I'm going the right way anymore. What's going on? I can't help but feel I'm going the wrong way. I'm lost in a room. I am lost in a room, guys. I mean, this is pathetic, even by my standards. I was doomed ever since the day Mom tried to drive to New Hampshire and ended up going past New Hampshire and driving into Canada. Oh, man. Good times. Of course, I was like 6 at the time that actually occurred, so I don't remember much of it. And what does that look like to you? See that shady thing? Nice music, by the way. Too bad it's not gonna last forever! Alright, boys. Let's roll. You, me, and a super missile. Did that just happen? And you could screw off with your Kamehameha, too. No, seriously. They're invulnerable when they do that, but it bounced off and somehow hit him again. That might be the funniest thing I've ever seen. I've never seen that. Ever. That was ridiculous. I bet you if I try that again, I won't be able to do it if I ever try that again. But anyway, here's a Chozo Elder statue. And I jump through the hands and land in it, because that makes total sense in the world.
Oh! I was drinking a soda, and I had my, I just reacted to that. Which either means I know this game too well, or I have really, really good reaction times.
Although I don't think I ever tell what my friend did once. We were playing beer pong, and, someone decided to bounce, and he's drinking a beer. His back is completely turned to the table. Completely turned. He doesn't see the bounce. He just... And he's drunk. He's pretty late. He's been like six beers deep and everything, so he's feeling it. He's drinking a beer with his back turned to the table. Suddenly just places his arm out and catches the ball that was being bounced. I don't think I'll ever see reaction time like that ever. I don't even know. What is that? Is that even like... Is that possible? I don't think a ninja could do that. Things bound to earthly shapes are temporal and frail, existing in a single dimension, fragile, vulnerable, and ultimately mortal. Not all things obey his law. Shapeless, they want to beyond the realm of perception, emerging only one feels who arrives who can feel their presence, such as the will of the Chozo. To defeat evil seeping into the planet's remains, to see the darkness meet its end. The will of the Chozo has no mind or reasoning. This will be the Trusted One's trial? Okay, don't know what that means. All I know is, yeah. Yeah. Remember this room, obviously, for Lair, because you see there are three things here. Three beams that have use here. Here's beam one, wave beam. Obviously, the next beam is going to be used a lot here, as you can tell by all the whiteness around the area. Now's the point where some delusional moron's gonna say, this game is racist. Why? Because there's a ton of white doors where the great revered statues are. I would actually believe someone actually saying that. As sad as it seems, I actually see that happening. Because there's a lot of delusional things you hear. Like offhand topics, offhand comments that have no racial charge to them or any real stereotype or anything, and yet people say, oh my god, that's racist. If that's the case, then I'm an extremely racist human being. I'm just saying. And I live in the neighborhood that's like, actually my neighborhood. Also, don't fall out this door. Because now that this is off, you can go flying. Actually, that'd be kind of a great feat for me to be a racist, because I live in a neighborhood that's like 30% whites and 70% blacks and Hispanics. So, and you remember these guys, right? Yeah, these are the stone toads from before. I'm just saying, if you don't know what you're supposed to do, you're supposed to do this. Drain the water. Everybody out of the pool! And now we have to get out of the pool. And I think scroll that stat. I think we have to scan that statue again, I'm not sure. I can't believe my Chozo lore got in this one area. I did not know there was so many. Pool is free of fluids. Yes, I really need to scan that again. Actually. Okay. So this is where you need to be, and right here is our next test. It is the stone toad. It's the stone toad test. Actually, it's not a stone toad test at all. It's more like just being aware that could happen. This is a save point, but that is not my what I came here for. That is another blockable door, and I want to make this jump because in here should be the ice beam! Finally! At long last, Samus has the power of a second beam. This beam, I'm not a big fan of. The ice beam's fire rate is terrible. Essentially, it's like a shotgun. However, it is mad powerful. And a charged ice beam is ridiculous. I mean, it's very, very powerful indeed. However, I would not recommend using it for fast enemies or a ton of enemies.
because it fires really slow. However, now that we got this, a Metroid has no chance. Because Metroids freeze to this. Let's do a punch of our enemies. In addition... Alright, that's Talon Overworld South, but we can't do anything there, that's the thing. And you notice there was a save point here, with a tunnel. Well, I can't really do much here either. Well, I do think one of these I can do just like one slight thing, but it's not even an expansion or anything like that. It's just like there. I don't remember though. Talon East. I have a feeling that is not the way to go. As you're supposed to do, and this will make it grumble. You're supposed to go back to Magmore, through Magmore, and back at the stupid freaking Fendrana, where you fought Thardist. Yeah, you're supposed to do that again. And again, and again, and again, and again. But now that we got the ice beam, there's another thing that has occurred. And that's the spawns again are shuffled. So far at this point, we've fought 4 Chozogos. Expect to fight like 19 more of them. Yeah, they are assholes when you get this thing. I remember once I was fighting Chozogos, like, seemed like 3 in what felt like every room, and I said to myself, if I get another one, I'm just gonna stop playing. Sure enough, we got another one. But this thing, I want to say, is doubly as powerful as a power beam, but it makes up for it with a terrible fire rate. Also, new enemy. Blood flower. Toxins are poisonous to the thing itself, so, that being said, if you have the ability to blow it up, you can kill it off very quickly. Come on. Good boy. Also, yeah, invisible platform here. You're not supposed to know about this, but until you get X-ray visor. However, you notice some really cool physics here. They actually took this into account. Look at the water. Look at the rain bouncing off the invisible platform. And if you're down here and you're observant enough, you can see it right there. Also, if you shoot that, you notice, hey, there's something there. I can jump, by the way. I hope you realize this. So you know what? Yeah, you're not supposed to know about this till right now, but I guess I'll somewhat break the game. I wouldn't even call it breaking the game, to be honest with you, because I think all it's left from this is to get a missile expansion. There's like every other damn thing in this game, it seems like. That was completely unnecessary. I can't make this jump. Or, you know what, that's inconsequential. But this is where I sort of want to be. Actually, wait a minute. I can't do shit about this because the spinner's on the other side. Well, never mind then. I can't do anything here. Or can I? Yeah, this is kind of on different sequence, so I'm... I made it. Missile expansion. So, yes, I'm not going to go to Talon East because that's going to lead to... This leads to something that actually, interestingly enough, can sort of... I'm not sure if it is. I'm not going to claim something I don't know. But Talon World East leads to this one area you're not supposed to be able to access really yet. And you're not... You really don't want to access yet. Until, because you're supposed to get a certain power up in order to properly navigate this area. It's kind of a spoiler alert there, but not really. But you can get to this area without having that, and Talon World East, I think, is the way to get there. Which leads to something I'm thinking of doing. Because I've never done this before. I mean, as I've been there in the past, but I've never actually fully explored it. With the simple reason it being that I always thought that was a bet. I sequence broke it, and that, well, not sequence broke, but I sort of irreparably screwed my game up, which isn't a good feeling. Anyway, there's gonna be more ghosts that show up, that's gonna show up here. So,
let me see if I can just shun the non-believers. This is gonna be interesting. Is there Hidoki me in the cutscene?
I like this. Please Hidoki me some more, jackasses.
I'm gonna move now, guys.
He's inactive. He's inactive.
Boom, baby.
I got one. I got two. I got to feel it. Where are you? Hey. That's three. Oh, hello. You're dead.
Yep. They have EMP blasts, evidently.
Apparently ghosts come equipped with EMP blasting technology. Come on. Bye. Nice knowing you, gentlemen. Okay, I believe I have the ice thing still in effect, but I'm not sure. Time to check. Okay, good, I did. Energy tank. This is the one real pop I want to get. Now, most of the rooms that I can unlock are going to have ghosts in them. Which leads to a very pain in the ass way of getting out of here. Like, the furnace is going to have stuff. If I don't leave this room... Okay, good. There's a crossway I don't think has anything of note. Near does the furnace, really. Except I just want to get the hell out of here. And if you don't have enough missiles, so... Yeah, it's not a fun area. However, I think I can use Talon East to help my cause. That other escape. And you know what?
God damn it!
I apparently left the room too much.
Fuck you.
I really don't like these fights. Is it because they're hard? No. They are hard if you're not used to them, actually. Alright, he's dead. Bye. Ow.
I hate these guys!
I hate these guys so much. I just don't like... I hate that music, that's why. I think if you don't destroy them, they leave you alone eventually. But don't quote me on it. Also, you can still see damage to them. When they're like that. Okay, back to the reflecting pool, and this is where I want to go. Alright. Okay, so I'm going to stop at the save point. For realsies. And the next time around, well, yeah, there's no ghosts in here, by the way. Just stone toads. Be nice if one of them swallowed me, but I guess I somehow avoid them all. So go me. So yeah, see you guys next time. 40 Warriors signing off.